guys, at this point in his career, Anthony Davis just entering his prime. Crazy to think when you look at what he's already accomplished thus far.
Here in the second quarter, about 3 minutes played. And stolen by James. And it's Dragic with the foul. That's his first foul. 1:56 left to play here in the second quarter. Caruso. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
Yeah, I mean, maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones.
Boy, you can just see the frustration growing on their faces. Nothing going their way.
It's something that happens to every team. You just have to ride it out, play your hardest, and live with the results.
And we are talking about Anthony Davis. How do you even put into words what he is able to do on the basketball field?
I mean, he's entering the conversation among the best big men of all time on a nightly basis, dominating in so many facets of the game. Really, it's remarkable.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. And one of the hardest working players you'll find, Jimmy Butler. At the same time, you know what, Chris? He's not afraid to challenge his teammates.
Yeah, within his team, he's a culture setter, Kevin. I mean, I think he's learning that balance of being vocal, but also knowing just how far he can push his teammates.
Here's James. Falls right in. He is 8 for 11 with that shot.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
And the official signaled the backcourt violation. Not very careful there. Here's Dragic. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Butler, no good.
It's a plus 5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And there's the call. Miami with the foul.
You love how effortless James makes this game look. Everything comes easy to him.
And the bright lights of L.A., perhaps too much for some players. But you know what, Greg? Not for LeBron James.
This guy thrives in the spotlight. The Lakers crafting a roster to satisfy his championship ambitions. Off the court, the City of Angels perfect for maximizing his business aspirations.
And it's Butler missing.
The defense has done a good job of forcing him into tough shots this quarter.
And that one's good, Caruso.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
Butler, no good.
He has shot them in the foot with his inability to make shots to the rim.
James, no good. Here's Dragic from outside. And he got that one up in time, but doesn't go in. And so it's Los Angeles in command with a 16-point lead as the buzzer sounds. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. Back to the action after this word. And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Lakers leading by 16. Here's James. A beautiful reverse layup. LeBron got the first basket of the third quarter for Los Angeles. Outside, Jones.
Get there, get there.
And he dunks it right over JaVale McGee. Holy cow.
He is a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
That could be a contender for the dunk of the year, I think. All players look for an edge, Chris. For example, certain guys are just so deceptive with the ball in their hands. I mean, you're always looking for whatever can give you that advantage.
Two of the best. Players and people can complain as much as they want, but Harden getting to the line is genius because he knows how you're guarding him, and basically you got to stay away from him to guard him because he's so skilled. And by the way, Curry does the same thing. And Curry, one of the smaller players in the league, but always finding a way to take the contact.